There was a young boy. His favorite drink was his orange drink, and he used to love it. And of course, the box had pictures of oranges all over the place. Actually, my daughter, she's about 2 years old. She loves the orange juice, the Israeli orange juice. It's so sweet. Like her, of course. So one day, they're strolling, you know, on the street, and they come to one of these vendors that sell the orange juice that you make fresh. And the kid's so excited. Orange juice, my favorite. And they give it to the boy. The boy takes one sip. It was bitter. It's like, what is this? It's something that's not good. It's spoiled. It's not orange juice. And so the mother said, what's going on over here? I tasted it. I said, no, this is orange juice. Like, what do you mean? It doesn't taste like the orange juice I have at home all the time. The orange juice that he drinks at home, the orange drink, is fake. It's fake. And since it's fake, it's sweet. It's delicious. It's candy orange juice. Real orange juice cannot compete with the fake orange juice. Reality, life is real, but what's more exciting? What seems to be where all the action is at? In the movies, people are trying to live the movies that they watch. And they'll never be able to catch that, the pace. You see the cutting, if you're ever into editing, the cutting pace these days of a movie is like, ba 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 ba. Life doesn't work like that, ba 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 ba. You can't compete with that. And so people are looking for that type of instant, that gratification, the rush, the excitement, and certainly the music. Every good movie has a good soundtrack, and our life just missing the music. Simple guy walking down the street, it's boring, but when you put the right music, it's like, oh my gosh, what's gonna happen? Unbelievable, with the right music. Dating is fake.
What?
Dating, you know dating, you never heard that word? Have they brainwashed you also? Let me teach you, well, once upon a time, what you maybe understood, there's a thing called dating. In ancient America, where we came from years ago or months ago, and then you took the blue pill and you forgot all about it. There was something called dating. Now listen, I'm a rabbi, or at least I look like one. And so I'm not about to, you know, I don't mean the dating that you might think I mean. I mean kosher dating. OU, stamp for approval, you know? You know what's a kosher date, actually, just a little bit of a side point? A date you could talk to your rabbi about is a kosher date. And that's actually what happens in the shidduch world. When you go on a date with a nice girl and you want to figure out what to make of that date, so who do you talk to? You don't talk to your friend. You know, you could also, depending on what kind of friend you have, but not like in the secular world where you might get advice from the wrong places. You get advice from your parents, your trusted friends, and your rabbi. Contrary to what the people out there might be thinking watching this, kosher dating is fun and exciting. It's actually amazing. You know, you're meeting a new person, and you know there's the conversation. You go to nice fancy restaurants, or at least the lobby of a fancy hotel. You could feel like a millionaire. Sit down, have a seat. Yeah, beautiful chairs, huh? $1,000 chairs. They're not mine, but the $1,000 chair. So the dating is awesome, right? But it's not real. Dating is fake. What's real? Marriage is real. Marriage is real. And unfortunately, the more secular you are, marriage is a word that they also don't know about. The religious don't know about dating, but really they date, they shidduch date. They're not religious, they don't know what marriage is really. They're not thinking about marriage. They're thinking about how fun and exciting dating could be. But it's not real and it never will be real. There's no commitment, there's no love, and there's no giving, no real giving. It's really, the dating process is all about what you can have for yourself. That's all about taking, and that's never gonna build a real relationship, a real intimate commitment and a connection. That takes marriage. And so we have to forget about the fake illusion of fun, of meeting a girl and getting to know her a little bit, and realize that the only way to truly appreciate is to commit and to give. And then comes real love, lasting love. And you build a family and you just keep on giving. It's a wonderful thing. You come home from work tired and you need to continue to give. You gave at work, now you gotta give at home. And the wives, they also give. They give all day to their children. They're always working. I don't want to kind of come off like a feminist, but you know, it seems to me, at least at our house, the husband's much lazier than the wife. You know, I mean, I'm just saying. The right woman and the right environment, you will see all of the true blessing and all of the true goodness that Hashem wants to give you. The dating is only to reach the conclusion that this is the right one for me, and then life starts, and then it's real.